Have you ever wondered why, despite the fact that most hearing aids have Bluetooth built into them, it isn't possible to connect them all directly with your computer? Well, thanks to a recent update from Apple, it is now possible. And once you set this up, it will revolutionize the way you hear everything through your computer. So in today's video, I'll firstly run through if your hearing aids are suitable, secondly, if your computer is suitable, and then finally, I'll run through the setup process in a few simple steps, meaning that you should never mishear any sound coming from your computer again. Here's a question for you. Why would you want the sound of your computer being channeled directly into both of your hearing aids in the first place? This setup will essentially give you the same benefits of wearing wireless headphones, but not just any wireless headphones. Here, we're talking wireless headphones on steroids. Not only will the sound be crystal clear because it's coming directly from the source, but at the same time, your hearing aids will take into account your hearing so that the sound you hear is personalized to your specific hearing loss. This process is possible with any made for iPhone, also known as MFI, hearing aids, of which the list is astronomical. However, it isn't possible with all of them. Those with the asterisks next to them on screen now can be paired directly with your Mac, and those without the asterisks can be paired with your iPhone, but not your Mac. So if your hearing aid is listed here, you should be good to go. So if you've checked through the list and your hearing aids are on there, that's great. Now you need to check if you've got the right Mac. Made for iPhone hearing aids can only be paired with select Mac computers, those that have the M1 chip and all Mac computers that have the M2 chip. If your Mac is one of these models, then everything should work well for you. To check the model of your Mac, head over to the Apple menu in the top left-hand corner of the screen and then click About This Mac. As you can see just here, I have the Mac Studio, which is on the compatibility list. Before this will work, however, you'll also need to ensure that you've updated your Mac operating system to Sonoma, as you can see that it says here as well. To check if your system needs updating, again click on the Apple menu, and then this time click on the System Settings icon. Then go down to General and over to Software Updates. When this is all done, jump over to the next step to connect your hearing aids. Now that you know that both your hearing aids and your Apple Mac are suitable, let's go through a few simple steps to get them paired. Step one is to head over to the Apple menu in the top left-hand corner of the screen again, and then click on System Settings. Almost halfway down on the left-hand side here, you will see the blue accessibility icon. Click into this menu. Now you should see the Hearing menu. Click on Hearing Devices, which is shown at the top here. At this point, you'll need to put your hearing aids into a pairing mode. To do this, you have two different options. If you have the battery version, simply open and close the battery doors on both of your hearing aids, making sure that you have fresh batteries in each. Alternatively, if you have the rechargeable version of these hearing aids, simply place the hearing aids in the charger for 1 second and then remove them. Your name should now appear at the top of the screen along with the model of your hearing aids. You'll see an R for your right hearing aid, L for your left hearing aid, and an R plus L if you wear a pair of hearing aids. When your complete setup has appeared, move your mouse over the hearing aids that have appeared, and a box saying Connect should also appear. Head on over and press Connect for me. You'll only need to do this once, as after they're paired, your hearing devices will automatically reconnect to your Mac whenever they're switched on and in range. So, you're all good to go. You'll notice that you can adjust various features here, which is great in theory, but in my opinion, it's a bit of a pain that it's buried all the way here in this menu. And it's not ideal to have to come into here every time you wish to make changes. So, if you want to know how to display this menu up here in the menu bar, then check out this quick 2-minute video on exactly how to do so.